Today, the words made in China conjure up images of cheap goods, shoddy manufacturing, and faulty technology. In earlier times, however, China was known as the maker of fine silk, porcelain, jade, and the inventor of paper. This 5,000-year-old civilization, with over a dozen dynasties and equally rich traditions, has become the inspiration for a group of modern-day performers in the United States.
From one dynasty to the other, the people's mentalities and way of behaving themselves, just walking or just, you know, one hand gesture is going to be different from one dynasty to the other.
Chinese believe that their culture was given to them by the gods, and that to be worthy of carrying on that culture, one had to go through a process of purification called cultivation. While this tradition has been all but lost in modern China, there is a company in New York that is seeking to revive it. That company is Shen Yun Performing Arts.
Shen Yun is like traditional Chinese culture. That's our mission. Our mission is to revive the classical Chinese culture. Classical, traditional Chinese culture, which is, believe in God, as well.
All the artists, from the musicians to the dancers and singers, do a cultivation practice called Falun Gong or Falun Dafa.
Falun Gong, the principles of Falun Gong are three things: truthfulness, compassion, tolerance. And from these characters, you can see truthfulness is very much rooted in Taoism, which is a traditional Chinese belief. Compassion, very much rooted in Buddhism. So these are beliefs that have been in China for thousands of years.
The artists meditate and do slow-moving qigong exercises to clear the mind and purify the body. Similar to Buddhism, the practice emphasizes giving up attachments and being a good person in everyday life.
Chinese people, they always believe in God from ancient times. Even till nowadays, it's just when the communists started, they start banning all the beliefs and religions just to reinforce their own power.
China's ruling nationalist party fought the revolutionary communists in a years-long civil war that ended in its defeat. After the nationalists lost the civil war in 1949, many fled to Taiwan, officially known as the Republic of China. While it shares a common language and culture with China, Taiwan has chosen democracy over communism and personal liberty over state control. It is here that Falun Gong, once estimated to have 100 million followers in China, is practiced freely, while in China, the practice has been severely persecuted for almost two decades. It is in this context that Shen Yun, which is yet to perform in China, is given a warm welcome in Taiwan each year. It's not uncommon for the country's president to send flowers and a note of greeting to the company when it arrives. The majority of Taiwanese are religious, many practicing Buddhism, Taoism, and Confucianism. While Taiwan doesn't have cultural landmarks like the Great Wall of China or the Forbidden City, arguably the best of Chinese culture has been preserved in the hearts and minds of its people. Shen Yun tells stories from ancient China up to the present day. Those stories pass on the values that guided people throughout ancient China and still do today.
The ancient Chinese people believed that morality played a big role in Chinese culture, in just how society works. You know, if people can't behave themselves or if they don't believe in retribution, know, they're just gonna like commit crimes.
You see somebody doing something bad in a Chinese story, and then that person is finally found out and dragged away to prison, and the good guy triumphs. I mean, who doesn't like a story like that? Everyone wants the good hero to win.
然后这个节目能够这样子继承一个文化的传统。
Shen Yun has been performing to sold-out theaters in Taiwan for over a decade. This year, it is set to give 34 performances in 7 Taiwanese cities as part of its world tour of 20 countries, 150 cities on 5 continents. NTD News.